What type of dashboard do we need for our project? Hi, I'm Anne Emery, and I want to talk to you about something that's a little bit controversial in the dashboard space, and that's that there are 4 different types of dashboards, all correct types. We might need one, we might need all 4, every audience and every project is a little bit different, because here's what I don't want to happen. I don't want the audience to have one idea in their mind of what they wanted, and then we as the dashboard designers, have a different idea in our mind about what they might want or what might be useful. And you put those 2 different ideas together, and sometimes you get really lucky. Sometimes you do, and there is a perfect fit. But more often than not, there might be a little bit of a mismatch between what our audience wanted and what we've made for them with our best guess and the best information that we've got at the time. I might see a mismatch between static or interactive. So sometimes the audience really wants an interactive dashboard or a dynamic dashboard with all of the checkboxes and dropdowns. But then sometimes I see people make a static dashboard, like a PDF or a handout. Or, much more commonly, this is the one I typically see, I see the reverse, where the audience really just needs a static PDF. They just need an email attachment. They just need, for those in-person meetings, they just need you to print it and bring it and put it on the conference room table in front of them so they can focus during the meeting and underline things themselves during that time. Sometimes that's what they really need, but then we're like, oh, let's make an interactive dashboard with all the bells and whistles and all the sparkly interactivity. I'm guilty of that. Another mismatch I often see is that the audience might really need an overview, but we might give them disaggregated data that's really detailed and we drill down on all of the specific projects. Or, more commonly, I see the reverse. I see them actually want disaggregated data. Project A and Project B and Project C, all separate, all individualized and very actionable. We might actually give them the overview, the aggregated view. So these are the types of mismatches that I see and I would love to just avoid. Let's be a little bit proactive and talk about these differences up front to make sure that the right data is delivered to the right person at the right time, so it's really useful and actually informs decisions. So let's talk through these 4 types in a little bit more detail. I'm gonna let you keep this very detailed diagram I'm about to show you. You can download it, you can discuss it with your colleagues at the start of a new project, please do, so that you've got that perfect match every single time. All right, so the first thing that you need to talk about with your colleagues is where your audience falls on these different spectrums, okay? So the first spectrum is the non-technical, technical spectrum. Another distinction here I'm gonna add is availability and time and just how much time do these people really have. You might have a technical audience that doesn't have time, so I'm gonna put them over on the non-technical side, okay? So if your audience is non-technical or busy, they've just got a lot of things on their plate, like a lot of supervisors with those long, long to-do lists, they've got so many things on their mind, they don't always have time to log in and look at our carefully crafted dashboard. They might want to, but they just don't always have the luxury of time. So we've got to plan for that. We have to plan for that. Okay, so non-technical or busy, I'd really put on one side. And then technical or people who do have time available, I'd put on another side. Here's the controversial part. I would say that non-technical or busy audiences, what they really need is a static dashboard. What they really need is the short PDF that's going to be shared as an email attachment or a meeting handout where you say, hey, dashboard user, please see the attached dashboard. Take a peek before the meeting if you've got time. We'll talk through any questions. We'll talk through some of the highlights together next week when we're together, okay? That would be perfectly sufficient for a lot of audiences. The technical side, or the people who do have time, they are gonna love that interactive dashboard. They're gonna love the clickable dashboards, the drop-down menus, the checkboxes, the little circular radio buttons, because they want to explore it. They're data people or they have time. Different dashboards for different audiences, different personality types, different time frames available. The next distinction that I would love for you to talk about with your colleagues is whether you're making a dashboard for the leaders or the doers. The leaders are going to need the aggregated overview. For example, one dashboard for the entire state. The doers are going to need individualized, disaggregated data, like one for every school. I used to be an educational analyst, so the first dashboard projects I worked on a million years ago, 15 years ago at this point, they were all about charter schools in the state of Maryland. That's the first one, you know, that it's always on my mind, that project. The people in the state education agency, they got a fuller report with the overview of how the state was doing as a whole. How are the students as a group doing? Tens of thousands of students. But then the individual charter schools, they got their own dashboard with school A or school B or school C. That's going to be a lot more actionable because it's theirs. They get to see their own data and improve upon it a little bit easier than if they just saw the overview of all the schools. The leaders on the top, they might need a single static dashboard. They might need a single interactive dashboard that they can look at on their computer and explore. And the doers at the bottom, they might need their own static dashboard or their own interactive dashboard or the option to drill down in the dashboard themselves. Then you can think about software options. I want you to think about your audience first and the software second. So if you're in this upper left quadrant, the single static dashboard, you're in the spreadsheet land. You can make those in Excel or Sheets or Numbers if you're on a Mac. You can kind of make those kind of on infographics websites. I'm thinking like Canva or PictoChart, kind of. In the bottom left quadrant, the series of matching static dashboards, like school A, school B, school C. What I like to do is make one template inside of Excel, and then I automate the process and churn out a bunch of matching dashboards. You can automate this process by writing VBA code. That's what I used to do back in the day. Sometimes I use drop-down menus that are linked to formulas, like a lot of drop-downs with VLOOKUPs and SUMIFs and COUNTIFs, or I use slicers. Now, if that sounds like jargon, don't worry. That tends to be a little bit more of an advanced spreadsheet skill to be able to do the coding or the drop-downs and formulas or the slicers. If you're in Excel all day, every day like I am, you might already be doing that. That might already be a pretty easy skill for you. And on the interactive side, you're going to be using typically either Excel slicers can do that, or if you have access to a dashboard program like Tableau or Power BI, those are going to be perfect for interactivity. Or you might be wanting to learn some code. I'm thinking of like writing R code to create interactive dashboards. That's another very popular route. Let's look at examples of a couple of these because that was a lot. That was a lot of jargon, okay? So the single static dashboard, here's an example from the Global Environment Facility. They're a branch of the World Bank. And this is one of their first dashboards way back in, I feel like we made this in 2016. It was a long, long time ago. They've iterated millions of times since then, of course. But this was a Excel dashboard. We populated this one template with some numbers. We made some quick visuals. We saved it as a PDF, and it was distributed as an email attachment before their meeting. And it was also printed out at their meeting for very busy, high-up leaders who, sure, they might have the skills to go and interact with a dashboard themselves, but they probably just don't have the time. So placing the key numbers right in front of them at a meeting is going to be the absolute best bet for that type of audience. A series of matching dashboards. These are those charter school dashboards that I told you I made way back in the day. We had to make dozens and dozens of matching dashboards. These were automated with VBA code in Excel. And more recently, I've been working on the National Home Visiting Resource Center. These are a page front and back for every state, territory, and tribal area that gets federal funding for home visiting programs. These were made in Excel as one template and then automated with drop-down menus and lookup formulas to connect everything. And finally, interactive dashboards. This is an example of Excel slicers. If you want to get started with slicers, they're easy, kind of. You have to set up Excel tables linked to pivot tables, linked to pivot charts, and those are all linked with slicers. It's your turn. Weigh in, comment, let me know, do you currently have any dashboards? I bet you do. They're pretty normal nowadays for most workplaces. Let me know, who are they for? Are they for a non-technical or a technical audience? Are they for busy people or people who have time? Are they for the leaders, the supervisors, the managers, or people who are more of the doers and need that disaggregated data? These are all correct answers. What I would really love for us is to create different dashboards for different audiences, single or series, static or interactive, based on what the audience needs, not based on what we need, not based on whatever software program we happen to be using at the time. I'm gonna let you download this, so look below the video for instructions. You can download this, discuss it, please, with your colleagues at the beginning of every project. Don't wait till the end, till you already have your dashboard made and you've spent a ton of money and a ton of time on it. Talk about this upfront to make sure that you're being really proactive and you're giving the right people the right data in the right format. I can't wait to hear from you. Thanks.